Let's see. I don't see some other players. One second. Okay, and we have with us tonight three players of the quartet, Finger Lakes Guitar Quartet, which is all located near the state capital of New York, Albany, a little north, I would say. And they have a variety of music to present tonight, and they will, of course, also spice it up with their comments. So without further delay, here are the three players of the quartet, and my word would be for Joel Brown to start the proceedings. Enjoy.
Joel, you're muted.
Joel, you're muted.
Yes. There
we go. Okay, sorry, that's guys.
Better. Oh, you're muted again. There you are.
We're off to a good start, huh?
That's okay.
I'm just saying thank you. Thank you to everybody who's out there tuned in. And we're so happy that we're going to be able to show you this concert tonight, because we thought it was just all gone. So we're very thankful to Joseph and to Kindred Spirits for having us be able to do a virtual concert tonight. And Joseph, do you want to start right off with the first piece?
Yes. Why would you start with playing and then we go further?
This is actually a piece that I wrote for the guitar quartet. So it's got a very complicated title. It's called Guitar Quartet.
great piece. Actually, I like it very much. Really shows a lot of facility in guitar too.
Thank you.
Was I not seeing you're actually moving there with something about the visual component then?
It was moving on my end, but if we restart the next movement, hopefully it'll work.
Uh-huh. Okay, sounded great, but yeah. I wish it would actually move.
It wasn't moving on my end either. So
yeah.
Well, anyway, hopefully.
Stopping and restarting, hopefully it'll come back.
Yeah, maybe our listeners, watchers also would like to know a little more details about how you got together, what brings you together, why is this particular name for the group? Would you extrapolate?
Yeah, do you guys want me to start? I'll start.
Sure.
I'm Joel Brown, by the way, and years ago, Sten Isaksen and I started a group called the Finger Lakes Guitar Quartet that was based mostly around Ithaca, New York, because the four of us had all studied at Ithaca College at various times. That group sort of fell apart because, you know, people went their ways and had different professional obligations and moved on. But Sten and I, once we settled in over here, he in Albany and me up in Saratoga Springs, we decided maybe we should restart the group because there were two other really fine players in the area, Paul Quigley and Brett Grigsby, and decided to reform the group. But we just really liked the name because it reminded us of our experience in Ithaca, but also the Five Finger Lakes reminded us of the five fingers that we used to play the guitar. So it seemed like a really good name. So if somebody else wants to jump in, that'd be great.
I'm Paul, and thanks so much for tuning in. It's a pleasure to actually be part of this group. As Joel mentioned, you know, the group had an initial, you know, they had started with a different lineup. Joel is actually he's a teacher. Actually, he's still my teacher. he was a teacher of mine at in college. So for me, it was a real honor to be part of this group. Sten and I, small musical world, we're actually colleagues at a community college that we both teach at. So I think it was it's serendipitous. We're fortunate, very fortunate actually, that there are four of us, you know, within you know, spitting distance, so to speak, where we can actually all get together and play and make, you know, work on this beautiful repertoire and such. So
I'm Sten Isaksen, and it's so great to be able to be part of a concert, even if it's virtual. So while I was muted, I was busy technically trying to figure out why the video wasn't working. So I wasn't listening to anything you guys were talking about.
We were talking about
it. It was
all
very interesting.
We were talking about this.
But I think the video is fixed now.
Oh, good.
Let's see.
Shall we go on to our next piece, Joseph?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, well,
let's continue.
This is a transcription of a very, very beautiful piece of music by Gabriel Fauré. Originally, this was written for orchestra and then transcribed for four guitars. You can imagine that the guitar quartet doesn't really have the repertoire that some, like a string quartet has, for example. You could choose from thousands of pieces for a string quartet, but guitar quartet, the repertoire is relatively small. So we rely on transcriptions. This is a beautiful transcription of a very beautiful piece called Pavan that Fauré wrote for orchestra. And I always like to say it's one of the world's most beautiful melodies transcribed and played by one of the most beautiful instruments, the guitar. Thank you.
That was magic. That was really great. I can only, of course, compliment for your great playing, but also Stan, I think you did wonderful recording. I mean, overall, everything, but this also sounds really great, really great. Also, acoustic of this hall, I think it's quite great. Yeah.
We were able to get it.
You were thanking me, but it really was Zankow Hall that just sounds fantastic.
Yeah, we were up in the Arthur Zankow Music Center at Skidmore College, where I teach.
Wonderful.
And it's really a wonderful hall. Yeah. Yeah. And you're right. It's a magical piece. And the guitars, I think, really bring it to life in a special way. Sten was playing on guitar what we call pizzicato. Pizzicato on strings, violin is when we use the fingers instead of the bow. But pizzicato on guitar is when we lay the palm flat on the strings and get sort of a thuddy kind of sound, which was really effective in this transcription. We also did some harmonics at one point where that very sort of transparent octave sound that happened in the middle of that piece that really makes it sort of haunting in a way.
Right.
Yeah. Do you want to keep moving, Joseph?
Yeah, sure.
We've got a piece now by a Brazilian composer named Celso Machado. Machado has written many, many pieces for guitar and always includes elements of Brazilian jazz, which you'll hear rhythms of the samba, of the choros. I can't remember what other ones are in there, but really fascinating music. And the three movements, first of all, the suite is called the Suite Amazonos, the Amazon Suite. And the first movement has a title that we're not sure what it means. And we've asked our Portuguese-speaking friends what it means. And they tell us that it's a play on words about a city in Brazil. But to us, it's not a very funny play on words because we don't get it. But movement number two is called Wind and Leaves. And even though it's a slow movement, you hear a lot of sort of fast motion in the guitar parts. There's a lot of rustling, and it does feel like the wind rustling the leaves, which we saw a lot of today up here in Saratoga. And then the last movement is sort of what we call the rock and roll movement. It's called the Dance of the Toucans. And it's a very lively dance that includes a little banging on the guitar once in a while and that kind of thing. So this is the Suite Amazonos by Celso Machado.
Peace and really good, feel good peace. What is it about Brazilian music that really feels so great? I mean, it's amazing. Also, I recognize also that Stan is playing seven string guitar, which is very popular in Brazil. There's some big virtuosos there in Brazil, but yeah, unfortunately, well, underreported here.
Yeah, the reason I bought the seven string guitar is I play with another classical group, Musicians of Malwick, and it's guitar, violin, and flute primarily. And so I'm often transcribing piano parts or taking cello parts and adding to the guitar. So I've decided a while ago that I should get a seven string guitar just so I can fill out the bass parts. And it has helped, of course, with the quartet too. Even though on that piece, I was mostly playing the melody on that one.
Very good. So I also want to just mention that you just did very well yesterday with the kids of the Delaware Valley High School. There were three groups of them, so we kind of had it three times there. And I hope they got the really nice encouragement from your playing. I mean, even I don't play guitar, but I'm encouraged maybe to start it somehow in the dark of the night. Sure. Nobody hears me.
We play cello the same way.
Okay. Keep that to myself.
My son is actually a very good cello player. I didn't tell you that before. Oh, he's a wonderful player. Yeah. Well, let's see now, guys. Should we go maybe Boccherini next?
Sure. Yeah, that was a fabulous piece we heard.
Yeah. Sure. So, Joseph, have you ever played this piece, the Boccherini? Have you played that Fandango quintet?
You know, I just explained to you, really not much into chamber music most of my life. But yeah, mm-hmm. No, Boccherini, I heard many times, obviously.
Yeah, sure.
I never played myself.
Well, Luigi Boccherini was an Italian composer, but wrote many, many chamber works. And this comes from a set of six guitar quintets that he wrote. So in other words, a guitar quintet would be string quartet and one guitar. And most of the time in these quintets, the guitar is just a part of the ensemble. It's not like a little guitar concerto. It's more of the guitar has a part to play, just like the violins or the viola or the cello. This particular movement that we're going to play for you is a very famous one. It's well known as the Fandango Quintet. And it's known as the Fandango because the last movement suddenly turns into a Fandango. So what we're going to play for you is the introduction and Fandango. Now, the students wanted to know at the very end of the piece, there's some clicking sound that I'm making on the guitar. And classical guitar players play with the fingernails. So all four of us have very short nails on this hand and rather long nails on this hand so that we can pluck the strings, and that's how we make the sound. So what I'm doing is clicking my fingernails on the side of the guitar. Luckily, it has enough finish on it that I'm not breaking the finish off. But it makes an exciting addition to the piece, and also it's written in the score as a castanet part for the cello player to play. So you'll hear in this piece, in the Fandango, lots of what we call rasgueado strumming, lots of heavy, heavy strumming, and lots of Spanish idioms all the way through. Even though Joseph was very quick to point out an Italian composer that wrote like a Spaniard. So it sounds very, very Spanish, but it's straight from the heart of Italy. So this is the Fandango, the introduction in Fandango by Boccherini.
Thank you.
Very nice piece of music. Great playing too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's an exciting piece. I think that probably all three of us have played that with string quartet before, haven't we?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it's yes. A, yeah. Well, yeah.
Very popular piece to play and so much fun always. Yeah. Yeah. Well, maybe we should play the first movement of our piece by Leo Brouwer. Does that seem like a good idea, folks?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Pull it up here.
Okay. So Leo Brouwer is a Cuban composer who just recently turned 80 and is one of the composers that you'll, well, we won't remember in 100 years, but people will remember in 100 years because he's made such an impact on the guitar world. Everything from etudes that our students play to very complex chamber works and solo guitar works, several guitar concerti, just a wonderful array of and variety of works from Leo Brouwer. This piece is called Cuban Landscape with Rumba. And we're going to just play the first half of it for you. And the reason we're going to stop at the end of the first half is that it's got a special thing where we're putting mutes on the guitar. And so what we did was cut out the cardboard pieces that we use to that our strings come in, and we insert them into the strings, and it makes a very unique sound. It almost sounds like a kalimba, like an African thumb piano, or a gamelan. And you'll hear rhythms between the guitars that create new rhythms. It's sort of like a rhythmic fabric, if you will. So this is just the first half of Cuban Landscape with Rumba by Leo Brouwer. Thank you. Good stuff.
Very different. That's for sure.
Very different.
No, I like that you present really very different styles of music. That's great.
I think it's important too. And he wrote other pieces with a similar title. The piece that he wrote, Cuban Landscape with Rain, is perhaps his most famous, which is quite an interesting piece as well. But we're going to finish the night with three Spanish dances by Enrique Granados. And these pieces were originally written for piano, but transcribed for four guitars. And each one has a wonderful character. Usually, in fact, I think all three of these that we're playing tonight have a form of ABA, where there's a statement, maybe 32 measures or so, and then a middle section that contrasts that, usually a little bit slower and a very different sort of style of music, and then back to the A section again. So each one of these is in that form, that ABA. And guys, do you have anything else to add about these?
No, not really. Outside of the original piano music. These are beautiful pieces that, you know, myself, I've listened to them for years. I love the original, the original music on the piano, and they're a lot of fun to play on the guitar.
You know, I must admit also that the Spanish music goes to the cello very well too. I must admit, you know, there's probably, you know, this intermezzo from Goyescas that's very, very popular on the cello and some other stuff. Something guitarish we can actually simulate on cello. You've probably seen some cellists play a lot of pizzicato, so maybe that goes with the territory.
Yeah.
Anyway, well, and also the kind of wide register that you can go high and low and all that. So
we try to imitate the cello sometimes too.
Okay.
not successful, but
do you have a little bows? A little bit. Like
Well, we'd also just like to thank very much Kindred Spirits and Joseph for letting us do this virtual concert instead of being there. We're sorry that we can't be there, but we look forward to maybe coming to visit sometime in person.
Yes, let me also say that originally this concert was scheduled for the Good Shepherd Church. It's a small stone church with beautiful acoustic, actually very good organ also. I don't know if you have any music for guitars and organ. But anyway, it would be really, really exquisite place also with great sounding, an atmosphere, all of that. Not a big church, small church, but really very well suited to this kind of. But thank you very much for presenting this for us, for joining us even through these times. And despite being here, I think we get a very good taste of what you're capable of and the nice variety that you presented. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So we're going to end with these three Spanish dances. Thank you, folks.
Thank you.
Great piece, great playing, and thank you very much again. Thank you very much for
doing it. Thank you.
And giving us such a pleasure. And thank you to you, our great audience, for those who joined us. And please see what's ahead of us in two remaining months in November and December by visiting our website, kindredspiritarts.org. And if you can make a donation so we can pay our artists, which is also important, please do that. Anyway, good night, everybody. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Good night. Wow.